Hello there. Welcome to the first session on industrial management. We are in Unit 1, Basics of Management. In this session, let us understand the term management, the business organization, also a sample organization structure. What comes to your mind when I say the word management? School, college, industry, in general, an organization? What is an organization? It is the institute which is formed by a single person. Later, he appoints people to work under him. There is a finance involved. A huge amount of capital is required, as you can see a briefcase here. There is communication, goal to be achieved, target to be reached, keep the progress high, duties and responsibilities allotted to each single employee. Flow of order from the top management, completion of orders as a responsibility. At the end, everyone in an organization is focused on end output, out of which an organization makes profit. Let us define an organization. So what is an organization? An organized group of people with a particular purpose, such as a business or a government department. At the top, we have an authority, generally the manager. Next, we have various department heads under who the team members work. The boss of the organization is the authority, and rest all the staff will be having a reporting authority or a superior. Since we are engineers, let us focus only on business organization. A business organization has various terms associated with it. We will try to understand all these terms in this particular unit. But right now, let us understand the base, how a business organization starts. Any business organization starts with a person's idea about a product or a service with which he or she can generate profit. To get this idea into action, he or she may need some resource persons. A single person may not have all the qualities to run the business organization, and hence comes the management. These are group of people who frame the policies and procedures to start, run, and to maintain the business. The management is the group of experienced people who are the masters in their field. For example, let us take a business model. Here the idea, that is the product or service, is the concept for the organization. You need to have a large capital to start or to run the business. Also, there are a lot of process involved during the actual production making or service delivery. You need to plan a proper network so that the product or the service reaches the end target, that is the customer from whom the profit is generated. By this, we can conclude the management is a huge task force who drives the organization through their intense plan and execution. Starting from the raw materials to the finished product, from machine to men, top managers to the bottom line workers, everyone in the organization is to be directed towards a common goal. Hence, the management is the process of dealing with or controlling things or people. Now let us see a simple organization structure by which we will try to understand the basic operation, process involved, and the role of staff in the organization. At the top, we have the CEO of the organization who has started this business organization. Next comes the board of directors, or it could be a single person, a managing director. There are various departments in this organization, starting from sales department, purchase department, quality department, engineering department, production department, and so on. Under sales department, we have sales manager, then a team leader, then the sales executives. Each have their unique role in this department. The primary role of sales department is to get customer's order. Later, this customer order will become the project for this company or organization. Also, on successful completion of the project, they need to deliver this to the customer on time as promised to the customers. For example, the customer needs a simple cable harness which has two separate end connectors connected to a single cable. We need to know that customer in our example is not a single person. It is an other business organization which may need this product as a sub-assembly. Who will work on this customer order? Of course, the engineering department. But before that, let us understand the role of purchase department. As in case of sales department, here we have purchase manager, purchase team leader, and purchase team members. The purchase department will be working on raw materials. Basically, they will check these three items in the present stock with the help of engineering department. If these three materials are not available in the raw material stock, the purchase team, in coordination with the engineering department and production department, will contact a separate supplier in the market. There will be various separate suppliers for each item. They need to contact the best supplier with the reasonable price. And this is how the raw materials get into the raw material warehouse. At the same time, quality department will check the quality and quantity of new raw material. Once it is okay, then it will be informed to the engineering department and production department. The quality department will have manager, team leader, and quality team members. Meanwhile, the engineering department will work on the design, drawing, processes, etc. The manager will manage the team. Engineering team leader, who is the expert, will lead the team, and various engineers in the team will be working on this project. The engineering team will make an initial sample of the product and they will send this to the customer. Once the customer is satisfied, a pilot operation will be run, which is the testing before the actual mass production. Here the time, process, men, money, and material required to complete this product are studied. When everything is up to the mark, they will calculate the profit or loss. And when the finance department approves the project, but only on the profit, the actual production gets started. We have production department led by production manager. Then there will be a process supervisor. Under him, various line workers will be working. The production department has to get drawings from the engineering department, raw materials from the warehouse through storekeeper. Using proper machine and process, they will convert the raw material into finished product. Now, these finished product before packaging need to pass a quality check, which will be carried out by the quality department. Once it is okay, it will be packed and it will be stored in finished product warehouse. From here, the sales department will contact the customer. Then once the invoice is cleared from the customer end, the delivery of the finished product will be made through logistics. The warehouse in the organization is divided as raw material warehouse and finished product warehouse. Usually, the warehouse will be managed by the manager of purchase department. But all the other department will have the access to the warehouse. Raw materials enter in through suppliers. The purchase department will be working on it. Once quality department approves the raw materials, the engineering department will issue the product drawing to the production department. Based on that request, the production department will convert this raw material into finished product. The finished product will be stored in finished product warehouse only after the quality check. At the end, the finished product will reach the customer. At the top, we have human resource department, which will arrange the men and provide all the trainings which are required in an organization to all the departments. Their primary role will be job recruitment, promotion, retirement, etc. Also, we have finance department, which will look all the financial matter in the organization. With this, I conclude my session. I hope you have understood the concept of management and business organization. Thank you for patient listening. Happy learning.